In this video, I want to talk a bit in detail about a very specific part of astronomy, of astrophotography, and this is cleaning optics. You all know that when you expose a lens to the environment over the night or something, the lens gets dirty, or any surface, even a mirror. Every surface gets dirty over the time, may it be from dust or from other things that may happen over the night, insects crawling over it. Or for example, with an eyepiece, you often have the problem when touching the eye that there will be some grease on the eyeside lens of that eyepiece. That happens regularly. And especially for that kind of dirt, you have to pay real attention. When you just have dust on the surface, maybe from over the day, this is not a real issue. But everything which is some sort of greasy may also contain light acid, and that can really damage the coating of the lens or the mirror. So, but anyway, let's talk about the amount or the interval of cleaning. So there is no fixed interval, of course, and you should clean an optic as rarely as possible. So if there's only a little bit of dust on the surface, just don't clean it. Wait until you will see an effect, because every attempt to clean it may damage the surface or may cause problems. Especially when you are in a hurry and just grab some sort of cloth that you have at hand and wipe over a surface. We all know that quickly wiping over the surface, this is the most critical thing you can do, because every little contamination, maybe it's a grain of sand which you can see, which you can't see, can scratch the surface, and this will scratch the coating of, for example, of the lens. And this is unrepairable. When that happens, the lens is damaged. And this can also be a problem if you still have guarantee on a lens. If you clean it improperly, that may cause problems. So the most easy attempt to clean an optic is with a very soft brush like this one here and compressed air. This is super easy. Something like this should be always in your bag. You should always have that around. And if you see there's dust on the front lens of your refractor, or maybe on a mirror or on the Schmidt plate, then just wipe gently over the surface, apply a bit of compressed air to it, and this dust will go away. Then you're good to go again, and you can enjoy the night. So, but if this dirt sticks to the surface, because it was exposed to moisture, maybe dew over the night or something, then the simple dust will really literally glue to the surface, and then you can't wipe it away with a brush. So still, you should not use just a cloth to wipe it away. You need a little helper. You should use a little helper. The most easy approach is to use distilled water. You can pour, for example, you have a bare lens. You can pour this in distilled water, let it be there for a couple of hours, and take it out, let it dry, and it should be good again. But most of the time you are in a hurry, maybe you are at a star party or you are mobile outside, and then you just don't have the time to wait a couple of hours for something to clean, then you can use another helper. And this is, in my example here, the Baader Optical Wonder cleaning fluid, which comes in a dispenser. This is super handy to have it also always around with you and with your eyepieces, for example, or with your camera equipment. And what you also use is, for example, microfiber cloth. That is okay, but has a drawback. I will tell you in a second. What you should use is just a box of tissues. This is what you need. The advantage of this box is you can be sure that a new tissue is always clear. There's no contamination on it. With this microfiber cloth, depending on how long it stays in your pocket, in your bag, there can be already something on it. And that may be a problem because you can't see it. Maybe there's a grain of sand here And even with a liquid, when you wipe over the surface, it will damage the surface. So a box of tissues is the safer way. Okay, so now how to apply it? With a bare lens like this one, or a bare mirror like a Newtonian mirror, or even the secondary, you can apply the liquid directly on the surface. This is okay, this is working. Just gently. And now we wait a couple of seconds, because this mirror here was super, super dirty. This was not clean for, I think, 5 years or so. And after a little time, we wipe away the remaining liquid from the inside to the outside very, very gently. Don't apply any force to the surface. So, this was cleaning attempt number one, and it looks pretty good. This mirror is approximately 30 years old, so there are already scratches and some marks on it. But now it is good to go again for some time. So we throw away this one. And the same principle applies to, for example, this secondary mirror here. Do it exactly the same way. But this was even more dirty. So the difference to eyepieces and mounted lenses is you should not apply the liquid directly on this kind of lens, even also not with distilled water. Never, never pour a complete eyepiece underwater or something. That is really, really problematic, because the liquid gets sucked behind this holder and it will stay there. It just can't dry out. It will stay there and mold will grow, maybe. And you don't want this. You don't want this on your optic. So with this kind of optic, you should apply the liquid to the tissue and then gently wipe over the surface somewhere like this. So, okay. Here we have to apply another drop. So the secondary mirror is also ready for reassembly. It's a matter of seconds to clean the optic properly, and this is all good to go. So last but not least, the eyepiece. Most of the time the eyesight lens of an eyepiece is dirty, and as mentioned with this lens here, we apply the liquid on a tissue and wipe very, very careful and gentle over the surface. Try to catch all the dirt that may be on the lens. But this is really greasy here. Maybe also somebody touches the lens. This is the same problem as with your eye. This is also the type of contamination you should be really take care of. Just dust will not harm your surface, but this grease maybe. I will also clean the inner lens. First I remove all the dust that may be on it. Now again, wipe gently over it. That's a nice little trick. Just unscrew this ring that you can reach the inner lens a bit better. If you can see any dirt on the tissue, just grab a new one. that is okay. You do it so rarely that this is not a problem. And then to check it, we try to get a nice reflection onto it to see if there are any remains. But this one here looks really good, no problems anymore. We reassemble it and good to go for another session. Okay, by the way, with this bottle of liquid you get also a manual where all these steps are described as I told you here. So if you want, you can read it also here. I hope this was of interest for you and it will help you to be prepared for your next session of astronomy, of visual or astrophotography. So thank you very much for joining us. And if you have any questions or comments, as usual, feel free to drop us a comment below the video. We would really appreciate it and so we can focus more on your needs. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.